Stop talking.
Please. For the past three classes, we are doing the chapter Activity-Based Costing and Target Costing. Now we will be doing problems involving ABC with target costing. Okay, see. Here, I will ensure that it reaches you. Question number 2 in ABC has not been solved. Now, that is a calculation related problem. No great concepts are involved. I have given you the blank spaces. I will type the solution and send to you through mail or something. Anyhow, I require your communication. And if you already given, not an issue. I will ensure that the solution reaches you through mail. Okay. Or if you want, hard copy can be collected here. I will give the solution for that sum. Nothing great to be discussed now. Otherwise, all the problems in ABC is over. Except for question number 6 and question number 7, which we will do today. ABC and standard costing. I will come to 6 and 7 later. Now we are going to do target costing with ABC. We completed section 2 target costing also. In which, the question number 9 is a practice manual problem. Very simple, nothing great. That I leave it as homework and refer. Other questions have been completed. Now, let us move to the section 3, ABC and target costing, where no new concept is going to be discussed. The two concepts are going to be merged and discussed. Please, let us recap. In target costing, selling price is equal to cost plus profit. Is cost plus pricing, right or not? The disadvantage is when the selling price is higher, the demand falls. When the demand falls, the unit cost increases, which increases the selling price further, which pulls down the demand further. It leads to vicious cycle where the product will be pushed out of the market. Right or not?
Yes, sir.
So the alternative approach is what? Target costing, where the equation is changed as target cost is equal to selling price minus profit, where we just change the attitude by saying that selling price I don't fix, it is market determined. Reduce the margin I want, the balance is the cost in which I should produce and sell. If you are exceeding that cost, try to do something to reduce the cost through the process called as value engineering. There we just do the design engineering by identifying value added, non-value added features. By eliminating the features, namely the aesthetic features, some part, I can save the activities required for do that features. When the activities are avoided, activity cost drivers will not be consumed. Activity based cost can be avoided. Like that we discuss about the process engineering also. How it is going to be done along with ABC, we will be discussing in these problems. Everybody, yes or no? Now. And then even after doing the value engineering, still you are not able to meet the target cost, compromise on margin, still not possible, exit from the market is the spirit of the target costing. In ABC, we said that cost can be classified into two types, direct cost, indirect cost. Direct costs are directly traced to cost object, indirect cost or common cost. Indirect cost can be given to the cost object either using traditional system, ABC system. Traditional system distributes to departments, from that to products. ABC distributes to activities, from that to the products. So here they assume that noun does not consume cost, only verb consume cost. Activities consume cost through their cost driver consumption, and we saw how to do the ABC problem, cost driver rate calculation and apportionment of overhead cost. What are the cost driver calculation? Activity, cost pool, cost driver name, cost driver quantity, cost driver rate. Then apportionment is activities, products, CDQ, amount. We just do the calculation. So many interesting issues and special points are discussed throughout the chapter. We will continue to do this in this coming problems also. Can I proceed or not? Now, few more issues here and there can be discussed. Everybody, can I proceed or not? Now, so now please take question number 12. Take question number 12. Now, it is now 6:30. By 7:30, we should complete question number 12. In another 15 minutes, I should complete question number 13. And another 15 minutes, question number 14. These three sum, let us try to complete it as quickly as possible. Okay, can I proceed or not? Now, please. I want some cooperation, some speed, alertness required, because then I have to do that ABC and standard costing, and then the network updation that will not take more than 5 minutes to do in the sheet. ABC and standard costing requires at least an half an hour discussion. Any apunjida, please. And I don't know, it is going to be touch and go. So if at all I can compromise on one or two sums in the target costing and ABC, and go for the standard costing and ABC. But only thing is, never waste my time by talking. Can I start or not? Now, last leg, yeah. Can I see it? No, please. I am going to read the question for whom? Okay, now please silently listen to the problem. Kaveri Limited manufactures two component parts for television industries. T, annual production and sales 50,000 units at a selling price of 40.6. Premier, annual production and sales 25,000 units at a selling price of 60 per unit. Kaveri includes all R&D and design costs in engineering costs. Assume that Kaveri has no marketing, distribution or customer service cost. Direct and indirect costs incurred by Kaveri on T and Premier are as follows. Direct material, variable. T 8 lakh 50, premium 6 lakhs, total 14 lakh 50. Direct manufacturing labor cost, T 3 lakhs, premium 2 lakhs, total is 5 lakhs. That's an alignment problem. Next is what? Direct machining cost. Look at the previous page. 1 lakh 50, 1 lakh, and then 2 lakh 50,000. Indirect manufacturing cost. Please, there is a problem in alignment. Make the corrections. Indirect manufacturing cost, machine setup cost is how much? 86,250. Testing cost is 487,500. Next is what? Engineering cost, it is 450,000. If I add the indirect cost, that is overhead, it works out to 10,23,750 is a total indirect cost. Plus direct cost, when I add, the total cost is 32,23,750. Everybody, are you understanding or not? Now, next. Kaveri's management identifies the following activity cost pools and cost drivers for each activity, and the cost per unit of the cost driver for each activity cost pool. Please, are you listening?
Yes, sir.
Setup. Description is preparing machine to manufacture new batch of products. Cost driver, setup hours. Cost per unit of cost driver is 0.25 per setup hour. Testing. Testing components of final product. Kaveri tests each unit of T and Premier individually. Cost driver is testing hours. Rupees 2 per testing hour. Next. Engineering. Designing products and processes and ensuring their smooth functioning. Complexity of the product and process. Cost assigned to products on special study. Over a long run horizon, Kaveri management views direct material cost as direct material cost and direct manufacturing cost as variable with respect to units of T and Premier produced, and overhead cost varies with the respective chosen cost drivers. Please. For example, setup cost varies with the number of setup hours. Direct machining cost represents the cost of machine capacity dedicated to production of each product. 50,000 hours are 3 per hour. These costs are fixed and not expected to vary over long run horizon. Additional information is as follows. Production batch sizes 500-200 unit. Setup time per batch 12 hours, 18 hours. Testing and inspection time per unit of production produced 4.75 hours. We'll check it later. Next, engineering cost is 1,70,000. Come up out 1,70,000. And next is what? 2,80,000. Make a change. 1,70,000 and then 2,80,000. Please. Kaveri is facing competitive pressure to reduce price of tea and has set a target price of 34.8, well below its current price of 40.6. The challenge of Kaveri is to reduce the cost of tea. Kaveri's engineers have proposed new product design and process improvements for the new tea to replace tea. The new design would improve product quality and reduce scrap and waste. The reduction in prices will not enable Cauvery to increase the current unit sales. I think you are listening on. However, if Cauvery does not reduce the price, it will incur, it will have a loss of sales. Expected effect on new design relative to T are as follows. Direct material cost on new T are expected to decrease by 2 per unit. Direct manufacturing labor cost of new T expected to decrease by 0.5 per unit. Machining time required to make up new T is expected to decrease by 20 minutes. It currently takes 1 hour to manufacture 1 unit of T. The machines will be dedicated to production of new T. New T will take 7 setup hours for each setup. Time required for testing each unit of new T is expected to be reduced by 0.5 hours. Engineering cost will remain unchanged. Assume that batch sizes are same for new T and for T. If Cauvery required additional resources to implement the new design, he can acquire these additional resources in the quantities needed. Further assume the cost per unit of the cost drivers for new T are same as those for T. Required, calculate full cost per unit of T and premia using activity-based costing. What is the markup on the full cost per unit of T? What is happening? What is Cauvery's target cost per unit for new T if it is to maintain the same markup percentage on the full cost per unit it had for T? Will the new T design achieve the cost reduction targets that Cauvery has set? Explain. What price will Cauvery charge for the new T if it uses the same markup percentage on the full cost per unit of new T as it did for T? What price should Cauvery charge for new T? Specify any other management action that Cauvery should take regarding new T. This is the question that has been asked. Okay. Now, will this question be asked in exam? One of the past examination question only. A classic problem regarding target costing and ABC. Please. We will discuss this problem in detail along with all the supporting notes. At the end, most of the issues in ABC will be over by this question itself. Only part is standard costing and ABC left over. Can I put it or not? Now, we need not hurriedly do this sum. Let us do it peacefully. Can we start now? Please. I am not going to give you time to read the question. Okay, please. I'll tell you the various parts and then proceed with the solution. Please, stop talking. Shall I proceed? Now, peacefully listen. We have to complete or not. Please. Can I start now? Let us not have the full question in mind. Let's go part by part. Always ABC question or ABC with target costing will seem big only. Because when they have to give data for doing the calculation. Bigger the question, easy to calculate. Everybody follow the because all numbers are what? Available. No need for assumption. Drivers are easily known. Can I put it or not? No. Now let me first tell you the ABC part and then do it and then move on to the target costing part later. Okay. See, this company is manufacturing two products. Name the two products. All of you. Name the two products. T and Premia. Respond. Yes or no? No. See, what is the volume? How many units of T? How many units of Premium? 50,000 T and then what? 25,000 Premia is the current volume. Am I right or not? No. Next. They given you the cost for this volume. 50,000 and then 25,000. They given you the cost. And you can understand cost as follows. Direct metal is a direct cost. Can be traced straight away to what? T and Premia. Direct manufacturing labor also is what? Direct cost. Can be traced directly to what? Premia. Even the direct machining cost is what cost? Direct cost. You know, I did not say direct cost, not variable cost. I said direct cost means what? It should be exclusively for a product. So this machining cost is also what? Direct cost. They gave you 1,50,000 and 1,00,000 to T and Premia. These are the three direct cost categories where I need not apportion between T and Premia. Right or not? But there are some common costs for these two. What are common costs here? Machine setup costs, testing costs, engineering costs. all this if I total 10,23,750 rupees, either overhead cost, let's be apportioned between T and premium. Enna apprinjida? Yes or no?
Yes,
now, this 10,23,750 can be divided by 2 and apportion it down. No. It will be apportioned based on what? A single cost saver or a multiple cost saver? They are given that here. Setup cost should be apportioned based on what? Setup hours. Based on what? Setup hours. Testing cost based on what? Testing hours. And then engineering cost on an ad hoc basis, where the manager make a special study and what? Apportion. And they're given that in the next page. Respond. Are you following what I'm saying? So they're given you the cost drivers for the three. Setup cost, apportion ratio of setup hours. And then testing cost based on what? Testing hours. And the cost driver of engineering is what? Based on complexity, a special study will tell you. Any apprentice? No. You need not calculate cost driver rate. Why you need not calculate? Given. Cost driver rate is 0.25 per setup hour, 2 per testing hour. And this is given in the problem in the next image. So no, no. That means no need to prepare the first table because they're giving you what? Cost driver rate straight away. Yeah, right?
Yes,
no. I had to find out cost driver quantity consumed or not. No. Further, they're giving you the T and premium details like batch sizes, setup hours per batch, testing time, etc. All these are used to calculate the cost driver quantity. On this basis, the first question is simple. Find out the full cost per unit. Find out what? Full cost per unit of what? T and premium. Using what system? ABC system is the question number one. Can't we do this together easily or not? Now, when I do this, up to this question over. Don't think it is big. It is not big. They give you what? Details. Patient to read and understand where the numbers are given is the only requirement for doing an ABC problem. Can I start doing the ABC part or not? Now, once I complete that, I come to the next point regarding what? The selling price and target costing aspects. Can I start or not? Now, give the heading. Target costing and ABC. Give the heading. Target costing and ABC. Target costing and ABC. At the end of this problem, I'll discuss one concept called as unit level, batch level, facility level and say company level activities, and then we can just go for the next problem. One theory has to be discussed. Okay, now target costing and ABC. Okay, shall we start? Now first write down part 1, full cost of T and premium under ABC system. Involve yourself. Part 1, full cost of T and premium under ABC system. I'm hearing disturbances, please. Full cost of T and premium under ABC system. Full cost of T and premium under ABC system. Can we start them? No. Step 1. Apportionment of overhead cost. Why I need not have the first step cost driver rate calculation given? Hence I dispense with it. I go for the second step. Don't write any exam step number 2. They'll search for step number 1. Now for us, step number 1 is what? Apportionment of overhead cost. Apportionment of overhead cost. Apportionment of overhead cost. Okay, can I proceed? Activities T premium within each CDQ amount. My main calculation is to calculate cost over quantity. That's all. Okay, CDQ amount. Can I proceed or not? No. Write all the three activity names. What are the activities performed by the company? Setting up the machines, testing the goods produced. That is inspection activity. Third is engineering designs. Setup, testing and engineering. Can I proceed? No. Right, working note number one. Calculation of setup hours. Can we start them? No. Particulars, T premium. Okay, production. Tell me how many units have produced tea and premium. Tell me the actual production. 50,000, 25,000. Batch size. For tea, in one run, I can produce how many units? 500. This only tells me how many batches are set up to be made. Okay, 500. Premium, what is the batch size? 200. Number of batches. How many batches of production runs has to be made? 100 batches. In this case, 125 batches. Number of batches, 100 batches, 125 batches. Every time I start a batch, the machine should be set up, yes or no? Setup time depends on the complexity of the product also. They given, what is the setup power for T and premium? 2.5 and 4.7. Sorry, 12 hours, 18 hours. Sorry, it is setup time per batch. 12 hours, 18 hours. Setup time per batch, 12 hours, 18 hours. 12 hours, 18 hours. Setup hours. Setup hours. How many hours? 1,200 and then 2,250. 1,200 and 2,250. 1,200, 2,250. Everybody understanding it or not? Now, are you all writing along with me? Everybody finish copying a canebosi. Go to the main statement. Go to the main statement. Write in cost driver quantity. What is setup hours for T? 1200 into how much per setup hour? Okay, now make a small change in the workbook. It is 25. Don't make it as point divide as what? 25. Please, 25. I lost my old workbook. Yeah, corrections there. Can I say 25? 25 into 1,200. How much rupees? 30,000. It is 30,000. Next. Next, what is set up of us? 2,250 into 25. What is the amount? 56,250. You can check it. If you add it, what should be the number? 86,250. Setup cost has been apportioned in the ratio of what? Setup of us. Everybody respond. Yes or no? No. Now, are you all doing? I mean, speed okay, Appa?
Yes, sir.
That's why, can I pose it? Now, next is working out number 2. Testing hours. Please. Working out number 2. Testing hours. Particulars T premium. I am going to test every batch, every unit producer. Every unit. Okay, now, testing hours. Production. Production. How many units I am producing? 50,000, 25,000. Production 50,000, 25,000. Testing hours per unit. Testing hours per unit. Testing hours per unit. Tell me how many hours? 2.5, 4.75. I made a change in the workbook. I think I noted down or not. 2.5, 4.7. It is typed as 4.7. I made as 4.75. Those who came late, change it. Can I see? 4.75. Next is what? Total hours. What is total hours? 125,000 hours. And what are testing time here? 118,750. 125,000 hours. 118,750. Can I proceed?
Yeah.
Go to the main statement. Cost driver quantity is 1,25,000 hours. In the how much per hour? 2 rupees. Here's how much rupees? 2,50,000. Next is 1,18,750 hours into 2 rupees. Gives you 2,37,500. 2,37,500. Check it. What the total of this? 4,87,500 is the testing cost which has been apportioned ratio of what? Testing hours. Respond yes or no? No. The third is what? Engineering. You need not do any working. Special study says what? 1,70,000 and then what? 2,80,000. Special study says 1,70,000 and then 2,80,000. The total cost is 4,50,000. And the overhead cost earlier is 5,73,750. 4,50,000, 5,73,750. If I total that, what is the number here? 10,23,750. That is the overhead cost. Total apportion between T and premium. So no. All the other costs are direct costs. In the written note now. With this, we complete the apportionment of overhead cost, step number one has been completed. Those have finished copying it, understood, raise your hand. Okay. Everybody comfortable? That side and the end la purinjadha? Can I proceed? Now. Those are back. Yes or no? Okay. Next. Step two, calculation of total cost. Step two, calculation of total cost. Particulars, T premium. Okay. Can I proceed? Right, the direct cost, first is one, direct materials. Should I trace or directly trace? Directly trace, 8 lakh 50, 6 lakhs. Direct wages, again directly trace, 3 lakhs, 2 lakhs. The machine expenses may be fixed, but it's not indirect. It is directly traced to your product line. Now, next is what? Direct machining. It's not manufacturing, wrongly typed, direct machining cost. Direct machining cost. And what is the amount given? 1 lakh 50, 1 lakh. Apportioned are directly traced. Directly traced. All these are direct costs. Okay. Don't think that variable means direct, fixed means what? Indirect. Not so. Traceable to a cost object? Direct. Apportioned means indirect. Can I say it? No. Indirect manufacturing cost, just know you apportion the first step. Tell me the amount, please. What's the amount? 4,50,000, 4,50,000, 5,73,000, 750. 4,50,000, 5,73,000, 750. Please. Total cost. What is the total cost of T? What is the total cost of T? 17,50,000. T total cost is 17,50,000. Premium is 8,9,14,73,750. 14,73,750. A counter check. Add the total of total cost. What is the total? What is the total of total cost? Tell me the number. 31,23,750. That gets tallied. Can I put it or not? No. Divided by what? Units. This is a cost spent to manufacture how many units? 50,000 units, 25,000 units. 50,000 units, 25,000 units. Cost per unit. What's the cost per unit? 35, 58.95. Cost per unit is 35 and 58.95. 35 and 58.95. First part, ABC calculation, full cost. Did you all understand it or not? No. Let's continue with the problem, please. Required part 1 has been answered. What is part 1? Calculate full cost per unit of T and premium using what system? ABC system has been completed. Are you all with me or not? Now, can I go to the next part or not? Now, second part. What is the markup on full cost per unit of T? Now forget about premium. We are now discussing about what? T now, from now onwards. Can I proceed? Now, I build up the target costing once I proceed. Okay, now. See, listen here. At present, I am selling T for what selling price? Sulupa. First page, what selling price? 40.6. The current selling price for T is 40.6 with a cost of what? 35. I am very comfortable, right or not? Now. But what has happened is, next page, they say, competitive pressure is increasing now. What is increasing? Competitive pressure, where all the competitors or new competitors are started selling T at what price? 34.8. That means, now people are started selling at 34.8. Answer me, can I continue selling at 40.8 or not? If I sell, what happens? Demand drops. Cost will what? Further increase. Then I'll be having what? Increased selling price. Later the product will be pushed out of the market. Yes or no? No. So what the question says is, if I don't reduce the selling price, my demand will fall. If I reduce my selling price, will demand increase or no? It will be maintained. The question is clear about that. They say, the company, if it not reducing the current price, the demand will not fall. If it reduces, the current demand can sustain. Now the question is, to sell a 34.8, my cost is 35. That means I should go for what? A value engineering program for that a new design called as what? New T has been developed. For which the cost drivers are given in the next point of the question. Are you following the question or not? Now, so now very simple. Tell me, at present I am selling T for how much rupees? 40.6. My peers are selling at how much rupees? 34.8. Can I continue to sell at 40.6? No. I have to slash down to what? 34.8. In that case, I cannot manufacture what? 35. I should go for a target cost. You can find out later. So, no. Now, to achieve the target cost, I should go for what? Value engineering. A new design of T has been what? Developed. For new T, they are giving you the cost drivers in the next paragraph. From A to F. Everybody, yes or no? Now, in this background, can I start doing the solution further or not? Now, the question part 2 is, what is the markup on full cost of T? Can I proceed right now? Next. Part 2. Markup on full cost for T. Markup on full cost of T. Markup on full cost of T. Selling price. What is the selling price? 40.6. Selling price 40.6. What is the total cost? 35. This 35 is approximate, very accurate. Accurate. I use the cost drivers to trace it. One cannot say it is arbitrary. It is traced as much as possible. Okay, 35. What is the markup I'm having? 5.6. The markup is 5.6. We can express profit as a percentage of selling price or what? Cost price. Markup percentage on selling price. Both I will calculate. Markup percentage on selling price. 5.6 by 40.6. Somebody tell me what the percentage here? That is 13.79%. 5.6 by 40.6, 13.79%. Percentage markup on cost. Percentage markup on cost. 5.6 by 35. Correct about? 5.6 by 35. How much markup on cost? 16%. Markup on cost is 16%. I want to earn 13.75% profit on sales or 16% on what? Cost is the company's markup requirement. That's what? Yes or no? Now, next, part 3. I am answering the question as they asked. Okay, part 3. Target cost for new T. Target cost for new T. All this we feel comfortable because we are discussing target costing already. Just the same concept applied here. Okay, target cost of new T. Target cost for new T. Can you start down? Now, selling price is determined by me or market determined? Market determined. Selling price, market determined. I don't fix it, I recognize it. Only the market fixes it. Okay, selling price, market determined. What is the current market going selling price? 34.8. Selling price, market determined, 34.8. I want markup of how much percent? 13.79 on selling price. I found out 16 question asked. I want 13.59 for answering myself. Okay. So 13.79. What is the number I'm going to have? 4.8. That means I should try to produce the new T at what price? 30. Target cost is 30. The target cost is 30. 35 rupees cost, I want to reduce it to what? 30. So what can I do? Value engineering. I design a new product called as what? New T. Above that, the A, B, C, D points have been given. Can I proceed? No. Let us read that and then proceed further. Please. New T. See, direct material cost for new T are expected to decline by 2 per unit. Okay. See. Direct labor is expected to decrease by 0.5 per unit. Machining time required to make new T is expected to decrease by 20 minutes. It currently takes 1 hour to manufacture 1 unit of T. The machines will be dedicated to production of new T. New T will take 7 setup hours for each setup. Time required for testing each unit of new T is expected to be reduced by 0.5 hours. Engineering cost remains what? Unchanged. Batch sizes are all going to be same. Now we have been asked to calculate the new T cost. Can I start or not? No. So can we do it together or not? No. Let us see one by one the numbers. Okay. Next. Part 3 or part 4 or part 4. Calculation of new T cost. Calculation of new T cost. Calculation of new T cost. Items computation amount. items, computation, and then amount. Can we start or not? Now, first, direct materials. Okay. Direct materials. All of you go to the first table. 8,50,000 rupees is a material for 50,000 units. Kadaba. All of you involve yourself. Yes or no? Now, what is per unit? 8,50,000 by 50 is how much per unit? 17 per unit. Now, new T will have the same 17. Reducers are reducer. By how much rupees? Yeah, 2 rupees. It becomes how much rupees? 15. Write out. It is 50,000 into 15. Bracket la 17 minus 2. Earlier it was 17. Now reduced by what? 2. 50,000 into 15. Understanding it? Now, what are the material cost? 7,50,000. New T metal cost is 7,50,000. Metal cost 7,50,000. Direct labor. Direct labor is going to reduce by how much? 0.5. Earlier, what is labor cost? 3 lakh. For how many units? 50,000 units. Now, what is per unit? 6 rupees. It is going to be 6 reduced as a reduced as. How much? 5.5. 50,000 into 5.5. 6 minus 0.5. 50,000 into 5.5, 6 minus 0.5 gives how much? 2,75,000 rupees. 2,75,000 rupees. Next, direct machining cost. Wrongly type. Direct machining cost. Okay. Will it change or will not change? Or they given you that machine time required to make tea is reduced by how many minutes? 20 minutes. Earlier, I was manufacturing in 1 minute, sorry, 1 hour. Now it has been reduced by how much? Yeah, 20 minutes. Respond yes or no for the tea manufacturing. I want to have a discussion here before I proceed further. See, the machining cost is given in the question as how much rupees here? 1,50,000. Isn't that correct? Please, how much rupees? 1,50,000. Okay, see, how 1,50,000? 50,000 units I am producing at 1 hour. At how much rupees? 1 hour. That means how many hours? 50,000 hours. It is what? 1,50,000. It is 3 per hour. Yes or no? No, correct? No. When I reduce it by 20 minutes, will this cost reduce or not? It is the first question. Reduce or will not reduce? Will not reduce because it is a fixed cost and not a variable. Yes or no? So, it is for the capacity hours, not for the actual hours. Fixed cost or capacity cost or volume cost? Capacity cost. It is for 50,000 hour capacity is how much? 1,50,000. Even if you work only 40,000 hours, still have to spend what? 1,50,000. Respond point number one. Yes, sir. Yes or no? No. So, reduction of the time, machining time by 20 minutes, does it have any advantage? No advantage. No advantage. Point number one. Why no advantage? Because the cost is what? Fixed cost. It is based on capacity hours and not based on what? Actual hours. Question is given. Yes or no? No. Next is, sir, it can give me advantage because when I reduce the time by 20 minutes, I can produce more units. In the same 50,000 hours, I am producing what? 50,000 units. When I reduce the time by what? 20 minutes, I can produce more than 50,000 units or not? Yes, sir. Sir, due to the improvement of new tea, I can increase what? More production. The question arises now. Will I produce more? I will not because I don't have a demand. Yes, I will rather keep the capacity idle than what? Produce because if I produce more than 50,000 units, I will be selling only what? 50,000 because the price reduction is required to sustain the existing demand. I cannot sell more units. Question specific. That means the 20 minutes reduction will not save cost because the cost is what? Fixed. Will not improve the output because I don't have a demand. Then you can say, sir, T is not a problem. Premier has a demand or not? Why can't I reduce the time and produce 50,000 units of tea within what? 50,000 of us. Balance of us, why can't I give it to what? Premier. That gives a benefit or not? But the question says the machine is fully dedicated to what? Tea. It can produce what? Premier. It's a direct machining cost. No, yes or no? That means there is no use in reducing the time by what? 20 minutes. It is a non-value added benefit which I am getting. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? Now, we have to give all these three reasons why the 20 minutes does not give you any impact. These are all the issues I wanted to discuss. More issues are going to be discussed in the later stages. Any apprentice? No. Tell me, 1 hour I was taking the manufacture tea or not?
Yes, sir.
Now, I stayed how many minutes? 20 minutes. We are having a joy or not?
Yes,
no issue, because whether I take 1 hour or 40 minutes, it will not impact me, because the machining cost is what? Fix that. It is based on capacity hours and not what actual hour. So no cost saving. Number two, can't I increase the volume? No, I don't have that demand. Can I use it for another product line? No, it is a specific say cost spent for a given product line. The product line cost. So no, all this makes the 20 minutes time reduction useless. Everybody, are you following what I'm saying? No, this should be understood. Please respond. So no, now write down straight away. How much rupees? 1,50,000. No change. I'll give the notes for this at the end of this sum. 1,50,000. Direct manufacturing cost, direct machining cost, over. Overheads. Okay. We can do it in the same slide. Overheads. Overheads are based on activities now. Tell me, what are three activities? Setup. First activity is what? Setup. Either setup hours reduced or increased or reduced. From 7.5, it has been reduced. From 12 hours reduced to what? 7 hours. Okay. But the number of setups did not reduce, because the batch size are going to be what? Same. Now tell me, how many batches? 100 batches. How you know 100 batches? 50,000 divided by 500. Already there in the previous working note. Yes or no? 100 batches. And how many hours per batch? 7 hours per batch. Into how much rupees? 25. 100 batches at 7 hours per batch into 25. Tell me the amount. 17,500. Testing. I test every unit. Testing time is reduced by how much, sir? 0.5 hours. Earlier, how much I am spending? 2.5. Now reduced to what? 2 hours. I test how many units? 50,000 units. Spending 2 hours at how much rupees? 2 rupees. Cost ever rate is 2 rupees. What testing cost? 2 lakhs. 2 hours into 50,000 units into 2 rupees. Gives you what? 2 lakhs. Engineering cost, no change. Special study now. What engineering cost? 1,70,000. Engineering cost is 1,70,000. Total cost is the direct cost plus overheads. What the total cost amount? 15,62,500. 15,62,500. 15,62,500. This should be shared by how many units? 50,000 units. Shared by 50,000 units. Cost per unit is how much? 31.25. Cost per unit is 31.25. Nothing great, the sequence of solution. Everybody following up? 31.25. Can I proceed up? Now tell me, I have done the value engineering or not? I managed to reduce a 35 rupees product cost to what? 31.25. Is it achieving my target cost? No. I have to produce in what? 30 rupees. Still 1.25 short. Get up. My question is, can I increase the selling price? What do you do? Compromise on market. If I increase the selling price, wrong strategy, because it leads to what? Fall in demand, increases cost further, and pushed out of the market. Respond. Yes or no? No. But let us answer the question as they ask. Can I proceed or not? Now, see. Point number, part 2 over. What is the markup on full cost over? Part 3, Kaveri's target cost over. Part 4 is what? Will new T design achieve the cost target as a reduction target? No. Write down. The new design, write down for this part, continue writing. The new design has reduced cost. The new design has reduced cost, but fall short of target cost by. Has reduced cost, but fall short of target cost by. Fall short of target cost by how much rupees? 1.25. But fall short of target cost by 1.25. Fall short of target cost by 1.25. Okay. A smoke is coming up. Yes, where, yeah? Last class. Part 5, please. Shh. Part 5, selling price using the same markup, please. The question has asked you, we are answering it. Selling price using the same markup. Selling price using the same markup. Selling price using the same markup. Can I proceed? Write on first. Cost of new tea is equal to, we do it together. Cost of new T is equal to how much? 31.25. cost of new T is equal to 31.25. Add what? Markup. Add how much percent? 16%. On cost na, add markup at 16%. Please. Add markup at 16%. What is 16% of 31.25? How much is here? 5 rupees. It is 5 rupees. Selling price. What is selling price? 36.25. Selling price 36.25. 36.25. If you read the question last part, tell me what you will charge as selling price for the new tea. Tell me 36.25, yeah? 34.8. 30, because I should not change the selling price. Write down next. Part 6. No heading. Write the answer straight away. We should not increase the selling price. We should not increase the selling price. We should not increase the selling price beyond 34.8. We should not increase the selling price beyond 34.8. Beyond 34.8. Back reasons. See earlier notes. I cannot dictate once again. Yeah, it pulls down what? Demand. Increases what? Cost. Vicious cycle. That entire thing has been written once again. Same story. Different problem. Okay. Can I go see? No. See the notes earlier. Bracket close. The strategy is to, please. The strategy is to compromise on margin. 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 If it is not possible, sometimes my cost of capital may be too high, it may not be possible. Na? If it is not possible, what you should do? Exit from the market. If it is not possible, exit from the market. If it is not possible, exit from the market. Everybody understanding the solution or not? Now, one or two notes I want to discuss, and then we can go to the ABC and standard costing. Okay, write down notes. Please. Write down notes. Point number one. Direct machining time has reduced. Direct machining time has reduced by 20 minutes. Direct machining time has reduced by 20 minutes, but has no impact on cost. Direct machining time has reduced by 20 minutes, but has no impact on cost. But has no impact on cost due to the following reasons. But has no impact on cost due to following reasons. Can I push it or not? A. Point A. The machine cost is fixed. The machine cost is fixed, for which the cost driver is capacity. The machine cost is fixed, for which the cost driver is capacity. For that also cost driver is that, but not the actual, but what? Capacity. The cost driver is capacity and not actual hours. For which the cost driver is capacity and not the actual hours. Hence, it will not reduce. Everybody understanding it or not? Next, point B. With reduced time, can't we increase volume and decrease per unit cost? With reduced time, can't we increase volume and decrease per unit cost? Can't we increase volume and decrease per unit cost? Do you understand or not? Question mark. Tell me yes or no. No, because there is no demand. All the chapters are interrelated, TOC, etc. Nothing is independent. No, because there is no demand. It is better to keep capacity idle. it is better to keep capacity idle than build up inventory. It is better to keep capacity idle than build up inventory. It is better to keep capacity idle than build up inventory. Everybody understanding it or not? Now, see. Can the idle capacity be diverted to premia? Can the idle capacity be diverted to? Can the idle capacity be diverted to premia? Can the idle capacity be diverted to premia? Which has demand? Which has demand? Question mark. Tell me yes or no? No. Because. Can't the idle capacity be diverted to premia? Diverted to premia. Which has demand? Which has demand? Question mark. What answer? No. Because. The mission is specific to T. No, because the mission is specific to T. The mission is specific to T. Okay. Now, at this time, I want to discuss about a classification of activities called as unit level, batch level, product level and facility level activity. And because we have now gone through so many problems or not, we may have an examples to understand that and then proceed with the other problems. Can I proceed or not? Now, please. Please, stop talking. Can I proceed? Now, activities are performed. Okay. Activities performed in the company is classified into four types. I'll tell you the significance of classification. A very important point we discuss in one line in the study material. Okay, let us discuss the significance of this classification also. Activities performed in a company can be classified into four types. The four types of activities are unit level, batch level, product level, and then facility level activity. What types of activities here? Unit level, batch level, product level, facility level activity. One exam question for 5 marks where they give some activity, ask you to classify. Are you understanding or not? Now, I have shown you so many 5 mark questions like that. Yes or no? One question in TQM, one question in what? Theory of constraint, one question in target costing, we will discuss whether it's value added or what, non-value added, one question in learning curve, and one question in PERT, whether PERT or what, CPM. This is a regular theory question. We have discussed wherever possible all those questions in the respective chapters. So now these are the four categories of activities. Let us see what these categories are. Okay, please. Ultimate cost object one should identify, the main. What is the ultimate cost object? It is that which is going to earn revenue for the company. Yes, sir. Read or not? No. So in that case, here every unit of T and pre, let's take this problem. T and pre is what? Ultimate cost object. No. Some activities are done for every unit produced. For what? Every unit produced, some activities are done. Everybody following? Huh? One example is in this problem, I inspect every unit produced. Yes, that inspection is an activity done for a batch, done for a product line, every unit, that is called as unit level activity. So when the company decides to inspect each and every unit produced, the inspection activity takes place for a batch, each unit, that inspection activity will be called as what? Unit level activity. The cost driver inspection time is called as a unit level cost driver. The cost driver is consumed for every unit of cost object. Cost object consumes cost driver. Cost of that what? Consumes cost driver. So when it consumes cost driver, each unit consumes, now that becomes what? Unit level cost driver. The activity is called as what? Unit level activity. I am going to use the discussion in the next problem, standard costing. So the first level activity is what? Unit level activity, where the activity is performed for every unit and the activity cost driver. In that case, inspection time is consumed for every 10 units or every unit. The driver is called as unit level cost driver and activity is called as what? Unit level activity. It is incurred for each unit produced. It is purely variable. Everybody is on no. Next, batch level activity. He is not incurred for every unit, it is incurred for every lots or what? Every batch. We call as what level activity? Batch level activity. Classic example is setup cost. Yes, setup cost, what is the cost driver for setup cost? Setup hours. What is the cost driver here? Setup hours. The setup hours is spent for each unit producer, for each batch, So the cost driver is consumed not by batches of A and B, not consumed by units of A and B, but consumed by what? Batches of A and B. I understand that units influences batch, but the influence is not every unit. The influence is what? Every batch. Everybody, yes or no? Now, that level of activity is called as what? Batch level activity, where the cost drivers are batch level cost drivers. Everybody, yes or no? Third, product level activity. Third is what? Product level activity. Now, one example is, I'm introducing a new product. Introducing what? New product in the market. There's a marketing activity to build the sales for the product. Whatever. I give advertisement in newspapers, television, etc. I do lot of marketing activity. Is it activity or not? It's for every unit, every batch, every product line, it is for what? Product level, not for a unit, not for a batch. Facility level activity is not for a unit, not for a batch, or not for a particular product line. It is common for the entire company. One example is brand building. One example is what? Brand building. That is, the company brand is built through advertisements. Everybody, yes or no? Nah. When they go for a brand building, in that case, you can say Ascension and all builds brand or not? How many advertisement comes or not? Now, they don't do one business. They do what? So many services they provide. That is not for a particular service ad is given. It's given for what? The entire company as a whole. They build a brand. The brand building is for every unit. Brand building is for every batch or every product line. For a company as a whole, generally. This is called as what? The facility level activity. Everybody, yes or no? These are the four levels of activities. And these are four levels of cost drivers. Any approach? Yes, sir. Are you following up? Now, see. Understand this, unit level and facility level, for these two, ABC is not going to add any great value. Traditional costing system and ABC deals with these two same. Correct? Are you following what I am saying? No. Whether you use traditional costing or ABC, this is not going to change very much, because this is also per unit. Traditional costing also what? Traces per unit. This is also for what? Very common. I will trace only on ad hoc basis or no? No. ABC becomes very interesting only to do what? Batch level, product level. Because traditional costing, when you use a labor hour rate, when you use what? Labor hour rate, that is good for a unit level activity. Yes or no? But the labor hour rate will not be good for what? A batch level, because the labor hours is spent for every unit, but setup time is spent for what? Every batch. When it comes to batch level and product level activity only, the cost drivers are neither unit level nor the cost driver are what? Common cost drivers. There only ABC becomes superior to what? The traditional costing system. Yes or no? If a company costs are predominantly unit level cost and what? Facility level cost, well, minimum batch level and product level means, hey, let's go for what? Traditional system, no need to go for what? ABC. If the company costs are having substantial batch level costs and then what? The product level costs, then have to go for what? ABC. One more instance for ABC should be adopted in this case. Everybody, are you understanding or not? This is regarding the types of activities. Now, I given this with the help of examples in the sheet, unit level, batch level, product level, and then what? Facility level activity. All this, the notes have been given. Same notes repeated in the back of the workbook also. Since I gave notes related to some in a consecutive manner, this point has been included here for discussion. I think you all have gone home and read what has been discussed here or not. Every point discussed, 11 or 12 point discussed, all this we saw with examples in the problem. Enna parayda not now. So this is regarding the types of activities. Enna parayda not now, please. Don't talk. So I don't want to dictate the notes for that. That is, I've been already warned, given. If you want, write just a mention about that. Point number two or three. Yeah. Notes go to the point number two or three. Point number two, write down. Activities of an organization can be classified into four. Activities of an organization can be classified into four. Can be classified into four. A, unit level activity. Unit level activity. B, batch level activity. C, product level activity. And D, facility level activity. D, facility level activity. More, you can just refer the notes. Can I push it up? Now, please. With this, we have completed this particular sum. Now, please. What do is, take page 120, practice problem. Past exam questions are given. What is given? Past exam questions are given. Okay. Let us see how they are asking, just to get the idea about it. Okay. The practice problem, first two or three questions are detailed problems has been given that can be done quite easily with solution. Take part four. The one of the exam question, give two examples for each of the following categories of activity based on cost, activity based costing, unit level, batch level, product level, what, facility level. They ask you to give what, two examples. This is one of the exam problem for 4 marks. Enna tell me, respond. Easier, difficult, easy, one should know about them. Enna purinjuda? Now please take question number 6. Take question number 6. State with a brief reason, all of you understand and answer, state with a brief reason whether you would recommend an activity based system of costing in each of the following independent situation. I am just applying the question which has been discussed already. Okay, now will you apply ABC or not? Soluba. Company K produces one product, overhead costs are mainly consists of depreciation. Will you go for ABC or not? No, I will not go for the ABC. One product, no ABC. So no. Now, next. Now, one or two extra points here also. Can I say? Next. Company L produces 5 different products using different production facilities. You will use or not? Yes. You know, the cost drivers are different. I should go for the ABC. Respond. Just a minute, sorry. Yeah. Company L produces 5 different products using what? Different production facility. Common costs are less. Everything is directly traceable to the product. Yeah. Did you understand or not? So, they are, please. They manufacture 5 products now using same facility, a different facility, a different facility. In that case, the respective facility costs can be traced directly. We have seen this in just in time in machine cells. When I have a machine cell, the cell is used for what? A particular product itself. I can trace all the cost of the product. The indirect cost becomes what? Direct cost. ABC need not be implemented. So in the second case also, I need not go for ABC because the products may be 5. The facility also is what? 5 in number. The facility cost can be directly linked to the product. Next is C. A consultancy firm consisting of lawyers, accountants, and computer engineers provides management consultancy services to clients. There is a firm with 3 different activities. Tell me, AB should be used or not? Yes. Because lawyer, accountant and what? The others don't say form into the same category. So there will be apportionment required on detailed basis based on cost drivers. One should be using the ABC system. Next. Company S produces 2 different labor intensive products. The contribution per unit of both products is very high. The BEP is very low. All the work carried out is carried out on efficiently to meet the target cost. Tell me, ABC is required or not required? Not required. Reasons are as follows. Number one is the BEP is what? Very low. When I say BEP is very low, the fixed cost is less. Already have found out the cost to be what? Variable. Then there are only less cost drivers. Yes, sir. Yes or no? No. Only when I have lot of fixed costs, I should take them, make them as much variable as possible by changing cost drivers, identifying respective cost driver. We discussed in the last class.
Yes,
or no? For you to understand, are you following not? No. So, when I have substantial fixed costs only, I require the help of what? ABC to make it as much as variable by applying the chosen cost. Yes or no? Cost is predominantly variable. Now, most of them are unit level costs. When most of them are unit level costs, traditional or ABC, both gives you what? Same answer. Why should you go for ABC? Question arises now. Did you understand or not? Now, for all this, our background discussion is very important. Did you now understand the importance of notes and the point which I discussed point by point or not? Now, all this point has been discussed in some place or other in this chapter, activity-based costing. This is one of the exam question, and one more problem is question number 7, target costing. State whether each of the following independent activities are value-added, non-value-added. Okay. But when I say something, my answer is final, don't dispute. Can I proceed? Now, gray areas now. Polishing of furniture used by system engineer in software of a banking company. Solupa. Value-added or non-value-added? Non-value-added. Because due to polishing furniture and all, nobody will pay more money to the bank. So no, no. The banking services is what? Something. They were furniture manufacturer, no? Polishing adds what? Appeal, not for a banking company. So no, no. It is non-value-added. Next. Maintenance of by a software company of receivables management software for a banking company, value added. Respond is all known. Now, next is painting of pencils manufactured by pencil factory, value added. It is aesthetic feature only, but customers are what? Willing to pay money. So now, pencil can be there without the paint also, but when you put what? Cartoons, paints and all, children will buy easier. Is all known. Now, they will say there is a chota beam. What that? That's all you want. For example, like, no. It'll be what? Jairam bada bhimya. Can I say it? No. Next. Cleaning of customers' computer keyboards by a computer repair center. Value added. For that, you can charge the fees. It adds to the customer goodwill. Respond. Yes or no? And finally, providing break adjustments in cost received for service by car service center, value added. Because the break does not work, then it will be sent to jail. Yes or no? It is value added now. So, this is one of the exam question for 4 marks. Tell me, easy or difficult? Easy. So, this is regarding the ABC.